From the borough of Queens in Flushing, New York, welcome to beautiful Citi Field. Today, the third and final game in this three-game series between the Washington Nationals and the New York Mets. Which of these two will prevail? Next on the show. Number 35 gets the ball for the Mets in this one. EK, what's the word on him?
Well, guys, this will be his second start of the season. In his first start, he already got himself in the win column. He'll be looking to add to that here.
Daniel Murphy makes his way to the plate, and we are ready for some daytime baseball.
Washington, second baseman, number 20.
Hit hard to short to his right, Cochran. Throw on to first in time, one away. And here's how the Nats line up in this one. Steve, what do they have to do to take down a very hot team here on the road?
Well, the opposing pitcher here gives up a ton of home runs, so maybe these guys are just licking their chops. Wait for a great pitch to hit and then go yard.
Denard Span will stand in. He comes off an 0 for 4 in last night's ball game.
Well, it seems like it's going from bad to worse. He had a bad day yesterday, and he's hitting under 200 in his last 10.
Watches a fastball right there for strike one. These Mets, EK, as they take the field here today, all you can really say is they've been on one heck of a run.
But they are in for a tough test here this afternoon as they are facing one of the best pitchers around. But the way they've been playing lately, I don't think they're going to be too fazed by it.
Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. Bases are empty, one man out. A great pitch there as he couldn't get extended on that one, and he's down on strikes for the second out. And with a quick breather here, let's take a look at the defense for the New York Mets. It's brought to us by Majestic. Eric, what do we need to know?
Well, guys, remember, this manager has not jumped on board with all the defensive shifts. Still that old school mentality, plays guys straight up. So we'll see how that impacts this game.
Bryce Harper gets his first opportunity now in the top of the first with nobody on. Into the windup and the pitch. And he takes a cold strike, 0-1. So let's take a peek at our umpiring crew in this one. Behind the plate is Clyde Washington.
Yeah, Matt, Clyde has a bit of a reputation for rewarding pitchers that pound the bottom of the zone. Calls the game well, but we might see some strike calls below the zone that hitters aren't going to be too happy with.
Inside with the slider, and that'll back him up a bit.
I think he was trying to get that slider in on his hands, but I don't think he meant for it to get in that far. I think he just released it a little too late.
Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. Two out, nobody on. Grounded to the right. Walker's got it. Throw on to first. Gets him, and the side is retired. Nothing doing here for their first shot in a scoreless ball game. Steven Strasburg, the California-born. What do you have for us, EK?
Well, Matt, he's coming off a complete game victory in his last start. Looked great in that one. We'll see if he can continue that here.
Alonzo Cochran comes to the plate to lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
For the Mets, the shortstop, Alonzo Cochran.
And a fastball in the dirt that's taken for a ball. EK, these Nationals as they take the field here today. They were losers last time out, but still in a decent groove as they'd won 4 of 5 prior to that.
And that includes losses in the first two games of this series, so they just need to have something positive go their way. Salvaging the finale might just be the thing.
Strasburg looks in, ready with the 1-1 pitch.
Nope.
And he lays off for a ball, 2-1.
All right, now you've just seen two straight breaking pitches miss away. So as a hitter, you're going to eliminate that pitch. No way does he throw it a third time.
And a good pitch there as he got him to go after one in the dirt. And it's back to even at 2-2. You get that feeling? That'll be a pitch we see a lot of as this game goes along.
And when he's throwing that thing good, a lot of times that's where it winds up. So these guys are going to have to prove they can lay off that thing in the dirt or they're going to keep seeing it.
Hit to first. He'll take it to the bag himself, and the leadoff man is gone here to start the home first. Time now to take a look at Terry Collins' Mets starting lineup in this one. Who's the one to watch, EK?
Well, Matt, I can't wait to see if La Potencia, Yoenis Céspedes, can keep it going. He's gone deep five times in the last 10 ball games, but clearly he's seeing the ball really well right now.
Juan Lagares will get his first opportunity here. Took an 0-for-4 in the victory last night.
Well, guys, that's why they call it a batting average. He's been hitting over 350 in his last 10 games, but he had kind of a bad one yesterday.
Curveball, and that misses in the dirt for ball one. One out, nobody on. Fastball got him to swing through it. It's 1-1.
And you know what? These days, so many guys are throwing in the high 90s. It makes those mid to low 90s guys look easy. But I'll tell you what, if he mixes his pitches well, it can still be plenty fast to have to deal with.
Fastball not close, and he runs it to two balls and a strike.
Well, that two-seam fastball ran a little too much off the plate, but now that sets him up to work with something away and maybe even an off-speed pitch.
Fastball is looked at for strike two.
A little conviction behind that fastball.
Bases are empty, one man out. And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2. Bryant Tiner will be next. In the dirt, but swung on and missed. And the throw is made to record the second out of the inning. And with that, let's take a look at how the Nats will align themselves defensively. It's brought to us by Majestic. Any thoughts, Eric?
Well, guys, somebody you don't want to test in this outfield, the left fielder. He's got a very good arm, very aggressive, charges balls extremely well, and covers a lot of ground.
Bryant Tiner will stand in now. Certainly a dangerous hitter as he ranks number two in the National League in home runs.
And he's also in the top 10 in batting average and RBIs. So not just hitting those home runs, he's having a great year overall at the plate.
First pitch on its way. And this ball is crushed deep down the right field line. And it'll fade just at the end and winds up a long foul ball. Bases are empty here with two men out. Another one fouled off, and he's quickly behind 0-2. That misses, says the home plate umpire. 1-2. Where it misses, I'm not quite sure.
Not too sure how you take that one on 0-2.
Yeah, not too sure how you call it a ball either.
Swing and a miss. Blew the fastball right by him, and the inning is over. Mets go down 1-2-3. After one, no score. Wilson Ramos will stand in here. He drove in one of their two runs in last night's ball game.
Well, guys, one good game does not a season make. He's been hitting under 250 over his last 10 games, so hopefully he's figured something out.
Now he lifts a high pop-up, drifting into foul territory on the right side. And reined in, one away.
Batting fifth, third base.
So one gone now as we give you a look at where these two teams find themselves entering play in the National League's Eastern Division race. Ryan Zimmerman will stand in, and as you can see, the numbers away from home, he's been much better once he gets out on the road. First pitch of the at-bat. And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one.
Well, you know, you hear it all the time because it's true. First pitch strikes are so important. It really changes the complexion of the at-bat for not only the pitcher, but the hitter as well, especially when you've got a good hitter up there.
Squared that one up just a little late. Into the windup, here comes the 0-2 pitch. Swing and he pops him up over toward foul territory. And this is going to wind up a foul ball. A little bit off the outside, it's 1-2.
Yeah, that's the put-away curveball. A great pitch with two strikes. You start it in the zone and then let it work out and see if he'll chase.
Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Set to deal on a ball and two strikes. Down the third baseline, Vinson takes it in. Throw on to first, takes care of Zimmerman for the second out of the inning.
Batting sixth, first baseman number 25, Adam LaRoche.
Adam LaRoche will stand in for the first time now, and he's got that average up over the 300 mark to begin play.
Well, it's still early in this season, but if he keeps this up, he's going to be looking to get paid in the offseason. His contract is up after this year.
Behind on that one, now behind in the count, 0-1. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. That's in there, and he's deep in the hole now, 0-2.
And you kind of get the sense that he's not really messing around out there too much. There hasn't been a whole lot of setting guys up here in this inning. He's just trying to get himself back into that dugout as fast as he can.
Ball, just outside. A touch outside, 1-2.
And that's a good spot for that fastball on 0-2. I mean, that couldn't have been an easy take.
Strike three called, and the inning is over. Nationals gone in order. We'll go to the bottom of the second, no score. Yoenis Cespedes strides into the box now to lead off the home half of the second inning.
And this is a guy that can make a big change in this game with one swing of the bat because you know he has big-time power.
I had him lunging at that one out of the zone, and that's strike one.
Yeah, he really pulled off of that one, and that's not the kind of swing we're accustomed to seeing from a guy like him.
Right, especially starting off an at-bat.
And he misses with it, 1-1.
Oh, look, if I'm calling the game, I would have gone right back outside and see if you could get him to go after another pitch out there.
No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
That's what you have to do against a big sweeping slider like that. It starts in the zone, and it's probably going to finish out of the zone, so that's a good job just to lay off.
Strasburg gets the sign. Here it is on 2-1. To 2-2 now.
And this is a guy who will not get cheated up there, and he almost came out of his shoes on that one.
A full count, 3 balls and 2 strikes. Basil Padilla waits on deck. A little late on the fastball, but he's able to spoil that one off, and he'll get another chance. Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. And a check swing here, but the bat clearly breaks the plane as he's set down for the first out.
Well, that's just some indecision there on 3-2. He's thinking, should I swing? You could just see him try and hold up, but by that point, he'd already broken the plane. That's an easy call.
Basil Padilla will stand in, and as you can see, his home and road splits there. He's been a much better hitter away from home. Breaking ball that's cut on and missed for the first strike.
Right now, they'd be lucky to just put one in play.
And here's a foul tip into the catcher's glove. Moves it to 0-2 now.
He's found a pretty nice rhythm out here early on.
Protecting on 0-2, so we'll do it again. Oh, and this is swung on and missed. 4 strikeouts already, and that's out number 2.
And remember now, he finished off the previous inning with back-to-back strikeouts. And now he started this inning with 2 more. So he's really got it working out there now.
Stepping in now, Robert Vinson. Now a swing and a ball popped high in the air over toward foul ground. And this is going to wind up a foul ball. Here's the 0-1 pitch. Here's one that misses high. It's 1-1. Still looking for our first hit in the ball game. Now a fastball that just misses here as the count moves to 2-1.
Yeah, even with the bases empty here and 2 away, you still need to be careful here. So he's pitched him smart so far.
3-1 now.
Well, it's looking like this might be their best chance to get that first base runner out there. And really, this has been one of the few guys that's even been ahead in the count.
And that misses ball 4, and now the Mets have themselves a 2-out base runner.
And I may not know a whole lot about pitching, but what I do know is this is not the guy you want to be putting on base with a walk. That definitely puts the stolen base in order now with 2 away.
Travis d'Arnaud set to take his first cuts with a man at first and 2 away.
Yeah, and he's going to have to find a gap to give that man on first a chance to score.
First pitch hack in here, and that's the first strike.
Oh, man, what a perfect pitch right there in a perfect spot. And that's exactly how you have to attack a guy like this. He wasn't...
Grounded up the first baseline. Oh, and he takes his eye off it there as it goes right past him into right. The throw to third.
Yeah, this is a ball he probably should have had over at first. Second, you see him come off the base to field it, but then it just gets right through him and on into right field.
Neil Walker will stand in now. Happy that this series is at home, no doubt, as you see his splits right there. A little tardy there. No balls and a strike.
There's not a whole lot of conviction in that swing. It was almost like an afterthought, like an emergency hat.
Chop foul right at home plate. Down and away, it's a ball and two strikes.
Well, I think that fastball is just for show there. He's not trying to throw this for a strike.
Here's the 1-2 delivery. Now a ball hit sharply toward third. And there's a base hit as the runner will score from third, and that gives the Mets a 1-0 lead.
Maybe he was trying to get just a little too cute there with two strikes, and this is going to wind up costing him a run. I think they're hoping to freeze him on a little backdoor breaking ball right there, but this one bites off way too much of the plate, and it gets hammered for an RBI double.
Number 35 will stand in with a chance to help himself out big time here with a couple of men in scoring position.
And a lot of times, pitchers go up there just because they sort of have to, but here, if you go up and just think ground ball up the middle, you might get one home, maybe two. This is a big time chance.
Looking to minimize the damage here. Swing and a miss on the slider, nothing and one.
Now here on the mound, you cannot take it easy on the pitcher here with two outs. He can still bloop one in there and drive home two, so you need to be thinking strikeout all the way.
A ball hit hard to the left side. And that's in there. Base hit. And they'll extend their lead even further as the runs in to score from third. It's a 2-0 ball game. And time will be called here as the pitching coach heads out to the mound and hopefully try and settle this guy down a bit. Alonzo Cochran gets a shot now with deuces all around. Two on, two out here in inning number two. First pitch coming, here it is. Now a swing and a miss. Took something off that one, and it's strike one. Here's a late swing and a miss, strike two. Runners on first and third, two away. And certainly no offer at that one. It's 1-2.
I think he's set up for that changeup again, Steve. Don't you?
I was thinking the same thing.
The 1-2 pitch. And this one is past him, and that could be a run. And the recovery will be in time. He's out at the plate. And a costly decision to try for it there as all of a sudden the inning is now over. So two runs on two hits, one error in the inning, and a runner left. We played two full. It's the Mets 2 and the Nationals nothing. Some fans still trickling into the ballpark as we get you set for the top of inning number three. Jason Wirth will stand in now to lead things off. 7, 8, and 9 here to start the third inning.
And maybe one of these guys can break this string of six straight retired to start the ballgame.
Here's the first pitch to him. And he takes a pitch that's ruled a strike at the knees. Pretty liberal strike zone there. It's 0-1.
Well, he's been in a tough stretch offensively, and this sure ain't going to help.
Line drive to center field. And a base hit now, as that's how the third inning gets underway.
Well, this guy's been absolutely wearing it lately. He's averaged down into the 220s, so if there was ever a guy that needed to put together a four-hit ball game, this is the guy. Got that first one out of the way.
Danny Espinosa will come forward now, back in the lineup after being used as a pinch hitter last night. And he starts the number eight hitter with a strike, nothing in one.
Well, that one's at 94, so the velocity's good right now.
That's taken. Now it's 0-2.
And I know it's your first at-bat of the ball game, and you want to work the count a little, but those were two pretty good pitches to have a rip at.
Nobody out, runner on first. Now the fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning.
I love this pitch right here. Just an elevated fastball with two strikes. Nothing much to it. He just says, this is just a good old country fastball, and he runs it right by him.
Into the box now, Steven Strasburg. And they'll try and play for one here as he gets this one down. Only plays to first, so the pitcher does his job as it's a successful sacrifice.
Yeah, this early in the game, to me, this is the right decision. You give that guy at the top of your lineup a chance to drive in a run with a simple base hit.
Here's Daniel Murphy now, as the changeup to him drops in there for the first strike. Off the plate and in, it's a ball and a strike.
And that's the right spot for that slider. Really try hard to tie him up inside. And that's a good job to lay off, too.
Starts to go around here, but it doesn't matter. This is strike two anyway. Skied into straightaway right. Tyner giving chase. And the inning is over. A golden opportunity to get on the board. Here goes for naught. Back with more of this Thursday afternoon business person special following this. Alonzo Cochran digs into the box in the bottom of inning number three.
And you know, guys, I love a guy like this leading off an inning for you. He makes good contact and he can run.
First pitch is a curveball that's inside, 1-0. Swing and a miss. Blew it right by him at 96. It's a ball and a strike. A lot of pitches up in the zone here early on.
And that's not the worst thing in the world at this place, but you've got to pick your spots.
Strasburg is ready. 1-1 on its way. And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1. Swing and a miss, as that looked like self-defense there. It's 2-2.
Got in his kitchen big time right there.
Still 2-2. Into the windup. Here comes the 2-2 pitch. Ball three. 3-2 now. Line drive to left. And a base hit, so the leadoff man is on to begin the inning.
Well, this is already a 2-0 game, and now the leadoff man's on again here to start the third. We've got a chance now to really open things up early and build up a nice, comfortable lead.
Into the box, Juan Lagares. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Yep, they sent him packing last time, so maybe they have a pretty good idea of how to attack him again right here.
First offering on its way. In tight here with the first pitch fastball that's 1-0. And you figure now this would be a spot where that man might try to take second base.
And it wouldn't be a bad idea to hold the ball a little longer out there on the mound. Really vary your times to the plate. You can't be predictable out there or he'll take advantage.
Swing and a line drive, but foul. A runner at first with no outs here. Throw over to the bag, and he's back standing. And again a throw and a dive, but he's back.
Just checking.
And yet another throw over. And he'll get dirty, but he's back in safely.
Why not? Make him get dirty.
This one's down to third. Fielded cleanly by Zimmerman. One there on the first, but no, not in time as he really took a tumble at second base, letting go of that ball.
Boy, and that's just a tough turn at second as they go around the horn. Now, he's got to hang in there because he knows he's going to get upended. And in the end, they wind up getting just the force on the lead runner.
Standing in now, Bryant Tyner, as he'll take a look at ball one. Seemed to quicken his delivery to the plate on that last pitch.
Well, you got to remember, the slide step does two things for you. It gets the catcher the ball quicker so he can throw a guy out, or it will hold the runner on first so he doesn't steal at all.
And he misses again, 2-0.
Now on 2-0, we got a fastball count, and we got a good fastball hitter. That might spell some trouble if he indeed gets one out over the plate.
Runners on first with one down. A strike and it's 2-1.
Yeah, you know, he probably got the fastball he was looking for, but on 2-0, you can look for one pitch in one spot. And if it's not in that spot, you take it.
Stung into the gap in right center for what should be extra bases. Around third and being waved on home. And a relay to the plate. A tag from Ramos, but it's not in time. Safe at the plate.
I got to tell you, I love the way this guy just lets it rip. Ahead in the count, behind in the count. It really doesn't matter to this guy. He's just going to go up, hack it. And he drives in a run right here as he just drills this one for two bases.
Here's the left fielder, Yoenis Cespedes, as he'll go after the first pitch and bounce one foul for the first strike. Tapped out in front of home. Ramos scoops it up, and the throw to LaRoche is in time, two gone.
Yeah, and you know, that's a nice play back there behind the plate. For a big guy, look how quickly he springs to his feet, gets rid of that mask, and then he finds the ball here to make the throw to first to get his man.
In now, Basil Padilla, as Strasburg will get ahead of him here with strike one.
Well, we've mentioned it already, but look at the pitch count here in the third inning. He's almost completely out of gas already.
Two outs here with a runner at third. That misses wide. One ball and one strike.
And I think that's been a big part of the problem so far. He just can't locate his fastball, especially in situations where he has to.
One and one, here it is. That nibbled the corner there, but missed. Two and one. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. Men on third with two down. And that misses, so it's a full count, three and two. A lot of deep counts for these guys early on.
And the more the better as far as they're concerned. They'd like to get him out of here as quick as they can.
Has to be thinking strikeout here. A fastball here, and this is softly hit and fouled off to the left. He's ready. Now the payoff pitch. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. One for the Mets here on the RBI double. We played three full. It's 3-0 New York. Denard Span is ready here as we begin the top of the fourth.
And right here is an important time for them to climb back into this one. They definitely want to even this one up sooner rather than later.
Called strike at the letters, 0-1. Now here's a line drive that'll make it out into left center, and he's going to have himself a leadoff single. Around first, heading for second now. Not in time, and he's in there with a double.
This is a good sign that he might be ready to break out of this slump of his. I can almost guarantee you that he talked about this with his hitting coach. Take the ball the other way. Use the whole field. You can do that, good things will start happening.
Here's Bryce Harper now. As he'll take a look at a pitch too low, it's ball one. Well, we'll give you a look there at the graphic. He's credited with double number 11 so far this year. No one out with a runner at second. 2-0. Looks like he's not going to see anything here.
Yeah, I don't think so either. They gave him two shots to see if he'd go out of the zone to try to chase. And after that, I'm thinking they should just put him on.
And he'll lay the fastball in here to get the count back to 2-1. Pretty clear the plan is to keep everything away.
And that's smart for most guys, but you've got to know your scouting report because this is a guy that can cover the outside part of the plate.
In there, and it's even now, 2-2. swing and a miss as it's dropped behind the plate. Darno gathers it. So good awareness that time as that'll go as a strikeout, but he's aboard on the drop third strike. Wilson Ramos will stand in now with two on here and nobody out to begin the inning.
And on the mound, he hasn't found himself in too many rough spots so far, so this might be his first real test of the ballgame.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Chop foul over towards the dugout. Nothing in one count. Here it comes. And he falls behind 0-2. Here it comes on nothing and two. And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning.
And with where that pitch was, there's no doubt he was hoping to get a ground ball out of this, but I think he'll be more than happy to take the strikeout instead.
Stepping in, Ryan Zimmerman. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time.
And Matt, with the double play in order, they'll obviously be looking to induce another ground ball out of him right here.
Starts him with a good rising fastball there for strike one.
Oh, boy, he is attacking hitters in this one. Another first pitch strike right there, and he's up right around 90% in that category so far.
Pulls this one in the air out to left. Cespedes has a read on it, and the play is made, but this should be good enough for an RBI as the runner from third tags up. And they are on the board. It's a sac fly and an RBI to make this a 3-1 game now.
And that's a good job in that situation. You'd love a base hit, but hey, the bottom line is you've got to produce a run, and he did.
Striding into the box, Adam LaRoche. He got called out on strikes his last time through.
And he was absolutely frozen with a good fastball. So let's see if he's a little more aggressive on that pitch this time.
He's ready. Here's the first offering.
That's a ball.
Too high, 1-0. Looks like he employed the slide step on that last pitch.
Maybe you see a little cat and mouse game going between the pitcher and the runner right now. We'll see who wins this duel.
Swing and a little tapper, but it gets foul. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. And they can't get LaRoche to chase there as that evens things at 2-2.
Well, I'd be surprised if they go back to the curve again on 2-2. He's had a couple of pretty good looks at it at the plate.
One run, two hits, one error thus far for the Nationals. That misses, and it's going to set up a big pitch now, 3-2.
And now the benefit of you working the count to 3-2 is that runner gets a head start from first with two away.
Sent on the ground out to second. Walker has it. Throw in time, and the side is retired. So one run on one hit, no errors, and a runner left. To the bottom of inning number four we go. The Mets are out on top, 3-1. Robert Vinson is set to lead us off in the home half of the fourth inning.
And they jumped out to that early lead, so now it's all about just adding on.
Strasburg steps into the windup. Here's the first pitch. Hit out towards second. Gloved by Murphy. Throw to first is in time for the first out.
And that's a good guy to take care of on one pitch, especially on a swing like that.
Travis d'Arnaud set to try it again at the plate. He reached on an error and then eventually scored last time up.
Yeah, still looking for his first hit of the game, so let's see if he can come through with that one right here.
Now the second pitch of the inning is sent on the ground out to second. Throw to first will get him. Already two away here in the home fourth.
The batter number 22, second baseman, Neil Walker.
Neil Walker stands in after hitting an RBI double his first time around.
Boy, he had a great at-bat last time up, and he'll look for another pitch he can drive right here.
Hot shot down the line, but a foul ball here, 0-1. Two out, nobody on. Off the plate, one ball, one strike. Breaking ball snaps in there for a called strike two.
Yeah, and it's tough enough to hit 95-plus mile-an-hour fastballs. That curve gives you something else to think about altogether.
This is going to find the crowd down the left field line. Count holds at 1-2. Frozen for strike three, and that retires the side. Down in order go the Mets, but they hang on to a 3-1 lead. Jason Wirth heads for the box to start off the fifth in this one.
And in a pretty close game so far, they'd love to see this guy get on base so they can get a rally started to get back in this thing.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. First pitch of the inning is taken low and away for a ball. It's 1-0. The pitch count there, one pitch into his fifth inning of work. Not much of a concern, I wouldn't imagine.
Yeah, it shouldn't be. He hasn't had any real overtaxed innings, so he should be fine for the time being.
Ready with the 1-1 pitch. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Swing and a miss at a ball tailing out of the zone. 2-2.
Well, you get the sense that what they need is one big hit from anybody in the lineup. If they could get one, it could get them right back in this game, because right now they just seem out of it.
Good eye to lay off the slider there, and he works it to full. 3-2 here. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. Full count here. Here comes the pitch. And a good eye here as he takes ball four, and it's a base on balls to lead off the fifth inning.
Just the first walk he's given up here so far to go along with just the two hits. So he's been pretty well in command throughout this entire start.
Settling in now, Danny Espinosa, as the switch hitter will take his cuts left-handed here.
He has really struggled against right-handed pitching so far this year. His average against righties is pretty ugly so far.
Chopped foul at the plate, strike one. Fastball, whoa, look out, that just about got him in the coconut.
He did not like that one bit. You know, it's one thing to work in with the hard stuff, but don't do it around the dome.
Pulled high in the air out to right field. Tyner moves over. He's got it one away.
Well, the only good news that comes out of this at-bat is that he stayed out of the double play. Other than that, this at-bat really didn't achieve a whole lot.
The pitcher, Steven Strasburg, steps up to the plate in a sacrifice situation, so let's see if that is indeed on right here. First delivery to him on the way. And they'll try to stay out of the double play here as he lays this one down. Throw gets him, two down.
You know, in this situation, some people may say, with one out, why not just let him swing away? You know why you don't let him swing away? Because he's a pitcher, that's why. All you can hope for is for him to go up there and make a productive out, and that's what he did.
Daniel Murphy will step in now. He's bounced out and flown out in his first two plate appearances. And he'll take strike one on the fastball, registering at 93 that time.
Yeah, I don't think I'd be in any big hurry to challenge this guy again. I'd see if I could make him go out of the zone, maybe chase a bad pitch.
Ground ball right side. To his right, Padilla. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. One left for Washington. They still trail it here 3-1. Number 35 stands in.
Leading up for the Mets, catcher.
And some number action 35. Out in that Washington bullpen now as we see both a left-hander and a right-hander throwing. He'll start him here with a changeup, but it's taken for ball one. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball.
You can bet he's going to keep right on watching until he gets a strike.
In the dirt, it's 3-0 now.
Now on 3-0, leading off this inning, you got to be smart at the plate. Let him throw you one.
From the windup, the 3-0 pitch. And a good comeback there. It's 3-1.
Don't be surprised if he still doesn't have the green light on 3-1.
And a called strike on the outside corner there. It's full down, 3-2.
Yeah, and it seems like he kind of got away from that pitch here in the last few innings. You got to think about bringing that one right back.
Swing and a miss, and he'll start the fifth the same way he ended the fourth, with a punch out, one away.
Yeah, he did a great job of battling back from being down 3-0 to start the inning. You know, things weren't looking all that good, but he didn't panic. He trusted his stuff, and he comes right back with three good pitches to get the strikeout.
Into the box, Alonzo Cochran. As he lays off a fastball too low for ball one. Looped out towards short. That's in for a base hit, and he's 2-for-3. So he's aboard with his second hit of the afternoon so far as we take a look at the league leaders in hitting.
There you see him, Matt. Third in the National League at the moment in that category. So we'll see if he can stay hot into the dog days of summer and even move up on that list. Having a great year regardless, though.
Juan Ligares will stand in here. 0-for-2 with a run scored so far. Strasburg comes set. First pitch on the way. And a good slider here to start the at-bat, but it's ruled a ball, 1-0. And they pitch out here, but nothing's happening, ball two. Here comes the 2-0 pitch. And he finds the black here with a curveball, 2-1.
That's a great call there on 2-0. The whole world's thinking fastball, but they drop the hammer on him.
And he lays off again, ball three.
Is he worrying too much about that guy on first?
I think he might be. Guys worry so much about the stolen base, but they don't realize that a walk is 10 times worse.
Now a throw over to first, but the runner's back easily.
Keeping him close.
3-1 our score as we play inning number five. And this is foul tip, so that runs the count full now at 3-2. Pause, now the pitch, and this one misses here. A close pitch on 3-2, but Clyde Washington rules it ball four.
You can't fault the pitch selection or the location there. It's well placed, maybe just a hair off the outside corner. But 3-2, that's where you want to be.
Into the box now, Bryant Tyner. And he gives this one a pretty good ride down the left field line. Harper is going to get there to make the catch a few steps into foul territory for out number two.
The left fielder number 52, Yoenis Cespedes.
Yoenis Cespedes digs in, and we'll see what he can do here with two on and two out here in the fifth.
Yeah, a couple of ducks on the pond out there looking to make that trip home. This is a big two-out AB right here, guys.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Pitch is a cold strike. The throw, not nearly in time, and it's a double steal.
Yeah, a little surprising to see him try and pull this off with two away, but they took a chance that the guy on the mound was going to be too focused on throwing strikes here, and turns out they were right.
Three runs, five hits, and no errors on the Mets line score so far. Hit to third. Zimmerman has it. On to first, and the Mets are going to come up empty here as that ends the inning. Two left for the Mets as the lead remains 3-1. Denard Span will come forward now to start out their half of the sixth, and they've found it rough sailing against this starter so far as he's yielded just two hits through the first five.
Not too many hard hit balls there either. He's had them off balance all game.
Here comes the first pitch. Took a little off, and it's in for a called strike one. For that man right there, just the one run allowed. The question is, can he make that lead stand up?
Well, he hasn't shown too many signs of cracking so far. He's got the look of someone right now who's ready to go the distance.
Swing and a liner toward the gap in left center. Now a dive, but he can't get there, and this is going to be trouble out there in left center.
Yeah, not a lot of offense to go around for these guys so far. It's just their third hit of the ball game, but at least this one's an extra base hit and goes for a double.
Here's Bryce Harper now, as he'll take a called strike at the knees. It's 0-1. Well, you see there on the graphic, that's 12 doubles now on the campaign. Now he reaches out for a fastball this time and drives it high in the air to deep left center field. And it will indeed get out of here. Gone, a home run. A two-run home run here for Bryce Harper. Sixth home run on the season for him. And the Nationals have drawn even now at 3-3.
This is just your classic fastball up over the heart of the plate. I don't even have to do a whole lot of analysis on this one. You put that pitch
there to this guy, he's going to take it over the wall. Simple as that.
Here's the catcher, Wilson Ramos.
Wilson,
as he will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls and a strike.
Yeah, same pitch here from the home run ball, but this one's in a much better spot down at the knees.
Bases are empty here. Nobody out. Just a bit late, and he's fallen behind 0-2. Trying to strike him out for the second time. Line towards center field. A screaming base hit here, his first of the night.
As we look at that again, you know, this is not a bad pitch by any stretch. If he throws this pitch 10 times, I bet he gets him out 9 of them. But here you just have to tip your cap to the guy at the plate.
Here's Ryan Zimmerman now. Runner goes for second. Swing and a ball line hard towards short. In there, a base hit.
Boy, in here you can't get angry at a hitter for hitting the ball too hard. But I think because this got to the outfield grass in such a hurry, that runner from first had to put on the brakes, or the hit and run could have backfired at third base.
Action in the Mets bullpen now. It's both a lefty and a right-hander that start to throw. Here's the first baseman, Adam LaRoche, as the first pitch to him is off the plate for a ball, 1-0. So after the strong 5 innings, things have not come as easily for him here in inning number 6.
Well, this is kind of the MO of this lineup. They have a way of just wearing you down, and they're starting to get into some better counts to hit, and that work's paying off.
First and second here with nobody out. And this is taken for a called strike. Oh, that's a tough call. Now 1-2.
Now you can't look for a specific pitch. You just got to protect the plate.
Hit hard towards center. That's in there. Base hit. And no sense risking anything here, as the bases will be loaded now with still nobody out.
Just amazing what this guy's done with the bat this year. I mean, even when he's in a 2-strike hole, he still finds a way to come through.
So a crucial moment here, and standing in, Jason Wirth, as he's presented with the bases loaded situation in a tie ball game.
Yeah, I think the entire game has led to this moment right here. Now we'll see if he can come through, or if the pitcher can somehow get out of this jam.
Now the New York manager's up off the bench on his way to the mound, and it would appear he's seen enough of his starter this afternoon. So he won't be able to win this one, and barring a miracle by the pen, would stand be on the hook for the loss should a run score here. Jim Henderson will be summoned into the toughest situation a reliever can face. Bases are loaded with nobody out. Jason Wirth will stand in against the new pitcher, and he couldn't ask for a better scenario as he stands in with the bases loaded and nobody out. Hoping to keep it tied, here it comes. Now a ball grounded to short, this could be two. And they finally get an out here as he's forced at the plate.
Well, it's a little surprising to me that he would take that chance here with the bases loaded. If he's playing in or even halfway, then it's a no-brainer. You've got to come home. But why play back if you know you're going to throw the ball to the plate? I mean, the reason you play back in the first place is to get that double play up the middle.
Standing in now, Danny Espinosa, as he'll take a look at a strike right down the middle. It's 0-1.
Yeah, definitely taken all the way. Not a bad idea with the bases loaded.
And this catches the zone as well. It's 0-2 now.
Now with two strikes, he can put the ground ball on the back burner and really go after the strikeout here.
Bases are loaded here, one man out. And a wasted pitch there, 1-2.
Yeah, and he didn't want that one to be in the strike zone. Even with the bases loaded, this is still a strikeout situation, remember.
Hits this one hard the other way. And a reach to his backhand side at second, but this finds a way by. They'll cash in here as the run is in to score from third. It's a 4-3 game.
The pitcher number 37. Steven Strasburg.
Now to the plate, Steven Strasburg. He successfully laid down a sack bunt in his last plate appearance.
Yeah, he did his job nicely last time up.
Good slider there, and he gets ahead of him, nothing and one. Three runs already home here. Swing and a miss. It's 0-2. Do you even bother with anything else here?
No, I sure wouldn't. As a hitter, you're thinking, look for fastball, adjust for an off-speed pitch. And so far in this at-bat, he hasn't made any adjustments.
Lays off that time, and it's 1-2.
He showed him that slider running away two times in a row. Now might be a good time to call in that two-seamer running in.
He got him, and it'll probably take a base hit now to get that runner across from third.
Well, you know, that would have been a good spot to help your own cause, but
second baseman.
I think any kind of base hit there would have been more of an accident than a real plan. I mean, he's in over his head, and it shows.
Antonio Bastardo will get the call here in a big spot as he inherits a bases loaded jam with two men out.
Antonio Bastardo.
Daniel Murphy steps into the box here in one of the bigger spots in the ballgame so far. Bases juiced now with two away.
Yeah, and this is one of those make-or-break moments in a ballgame, Matt. You don't want to let an opportunity like this in the middle innings get away from you.
Swing and a miss on the slider, nothing and one.
Oh, and he had a pitch to hit right there, too. He just didn't hit it.
Now a hard liner toward short, but this will find the shortstop's glove for the third out of the inning. But they strike for three in the inning, two on this two-run home run. On to the bottom of the sixth. It's 4-3 Washington. Basil Padilla will dig in now as he'll lead things off for the Mets in their half of the sixth.
Basil Padilla.
Now the pitch. Drops in a strike to start the at-bat, nothing and one.
And you can see him trying to be a little bit more patient here. He's got two strikeouts already, but he's got to be careful not to fall too far behind.
The windup and the 0-1. And boy, they're really giving him fits inside now as he can't get extended there, and it's 0-2 now.
Yeah, and he's really getting over the top of that curveball.
The windup and the 0-2 pitch. And, oh, he can't get out of the way of that one, so the leadoff man will be on to open the frame.
You just don't see that, like, ever. Not in that situation. Not in that count. That's a big break from an offensive standpoint. Now you've got to find a way to make that hurt somehow.
Robert Vinson will step in, a ground-out victim his last time. And that swung on and missed for strike one. Ike, the starter, creeping up on 100 pitches now, but that number alone doesn't appear to be affecting him too much at all.
Yeah, he still looks sharp. Still, with the way that teams handle pitchers nowadays, I don't think he'll wind up going much further.
Here's the 0-1. Boy, he comes back with a beautiful pitch there, and he's dominating this at-bat. It's 0-2 now.
Yeah, not a real good effort there. That pitch was never going to be a strike.
Here's the 0-2. And he struck him out. Strikeout number 8 now in the ballgame for him.
He's been able to get outs when he needs them with that curveball, and there you see what his pitch breakdown has been so far.
Travis d'Arnaud strides in, grounded out his last time through. He's set, now the pitch. Pitch out, nothing doing. Four-three our score here as we play inning number 6. And they pitch out here, but nothing's going on. Pitch swung on and hit in the air toward the line and right. And Worth will settle under this one and take it for the second out.
Now batting, second baseman, Neil Walker.
Neil Walker steps in, working on a 1-for-2 game so far. Swinging bunt to the mound. Throw on to LaRoche, takes care of him, and with that, the side is retired. It'll be Denard Span to lead us off when we return. It's the Nationals 4 and the Mets 3. Welcome back to Citi Field in Flushing. Nationals on top in this one as we get ready for the 7th, but first let's check out the game summary to see how we got here. And there is Denard Span. He'll lead things off here in this one-run contest.
Center fielder, Denard Span.
And he starts him out with a strike on the outer half.
Hard to call that an off-speed pitch when it's a changeup at 88. That's a fastball for a lot of guys in this league.
Off the plate, one ball, one strike. Now a swing and a miss, and he's behind 1-2. Pulls this one into the air out into right field. Moving under it, Tyner looks it into his glove, and there's one gone.
The left fielder, number 34, Bryce Harper.
Bryce Harper will stand in again as we flash you back to the middle innings here. This was a big blow, a two-run home run that really got his guys going. Starts him out with a slider for a strike.
Getting that first pitch strike is so important against a guy like this. You have to be able to work ahead in the count and not let him dictate the at-bat.
And that's in there as well, 0-2 now.
Boy, that's another pitch right down the middle, though. So he's gotten away with it so far, but I think he's given him a little bit too much to hit here.
Too high, 1-2. We're in the seventh inning now of a 4-3 ball game. And a swing and a miss here, so it's a quick two outs to start the seventh.
Well, this is a scroll he's taken five times in this series now. That slow walk back to the dugout after getting punched out. After a while, these things, they start to wear on you. You've got to try to keep the mindset that every at-bat's a new opportunity, but most of the time, that's easier said than done.
Here's the catcher, Wilson Ramos, as he'll take a look at a high strike that time. It's nothing and one. Really a good job so far by this guy out of the bullpen.
Yeah, he's come in and really put his stamp on this game. He's thrown a lot of strikes. That's what you want.
Bases are empty here with two men out. And that's inside off the plate with the fastball. It's 1-1. Way outside, nearly to the backstop, 2-1. The catcher wanted it down, and they got him to chase it for strike two.
Boy, when he's got that thing going good, it just takes a nosedive right at the end.
A little late with the swing, but he stays alive. Still 2-2. Two and two count. Here it comes. Gets on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate. Ready on two balls and two strikes. Here it comes. And that's in there. So perhaps some life here with two men out.
Boy, I'll tell you, these are the scary ones for a pitcher. This is going to give you a pretty good angle right here because this ball is hit so hard and it's just about right at him. I mean, there's no time to do anything out there. And he's pretty lucky that one didn't get him because it would have taken his head off.
Here's Ryan Zimmerman now as he swings and hits this one foul off to the right and out of play. And it's quickly 0-2. A pause and the 0-2. And wow, tough to lay off the fastball there, but it's 1-2. A look here at the hits per side here in the late going. Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. Ladies, Nationals leave one, but they hang on to a one-run lead, 4-3. Craig Stammen will get the ball now as he'll take over on the mound to start the home seventh.
Craig Stammen.
Lucas Duda will pinch hit here, and he's the potential tying run.
Lucas Duda.
Off-speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball. And they won't get him to chase the curveball in the dirt that time, and it's 2-0 now.
And down by a run, a leadoff walk would certainly help the cause. He's got to shrink that strike zone here and not chase anything that he shouldn't be swinging at.
From the windup, the 2-0 pitch. And he'll lay the fastball in here to get the count back to 2-1.
Boy, and this is why you're trying to get yourself into good hitters' counts. This is just right down the middle on 2-0, and swinging at this should be your reward, but he decides to let it go.
2-1 pitch, a knuckle curve swung on and missed, 2-2. Ran one in there as this is hit on the ground towards second. Murphy's got it and taken in out there for the first out.
We showed you his numbers a minute ago. It's still early in the season to be worrying too much, but he's definitely off to a slow start, so he's going to need to string together a few good outings to lower that ERA a little bit.
Into the box now, Alonzo Cochran. He singled his last time up. Now here's the pitch. He slaps that one away, and the count will be nothing and one. Liner towards second. Leaps high as he makes the catch. Well done.
Well, I'll tell you what, he had to get up for that one. Sometimes the leap is a little bit more showy, but not here. He was up there a good 2 or 3 feet to pull it in.
Here's Juan Lagares. As he'll watch one miss down and in for a ball, 1-0.
And even with two outs, this is a team that can still put something together here, especially in this part of the lineup, so you can't let your guard down.
Into his windup, here comes the 1-0. And he won't bite at that one either, it's 2-0.
This is a guy whose numbers are on the rise, and this is a big reason why. Two close pitches, two good takes, and now he's in a great hitter's count, 2-0.
2-0 pitch on the way. 3-0 now.
And that questionable call on the previous pitch, it really changes the at-bat because he doesn't want to just lay one in there on 2-0. Now it's 3-0, and the tide is not working in his favor.
And he gets this fastball over, back to 3-1 now.
Not turned loose there. I thought that he might be swinging with two away, but apparently not.
Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. And here's a ball hit in the air. And that will conclude matters here in the seventh. Mets go down 1-2-3. They still trail it here 4-3. Addison Reed will be summoned from the bullpen now, so he'll take over to start inning number 8.
Addison Reed.
Leading off the inning, Adam LaRoche, as they'll look for some added insurance before the bottom half of the inning. Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one. Hit hard up the middle. And there's a base hit, so a chance to add a little insurance here as the leadoff man is on to start the eighth.
Well, here we are. It's the second month of the season, and this guy is showing no signs of slowing down. He's got himself another multi-hit ball game here.
Jason Wirth steps in, working on a 1-for-2 game so far. Reed's ready. First pitch on its way. chopped foul right at home plate at strike one. The 0-1 delivery drilled to the right side. And that's through for a hit. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
Textbook start to the inning right there. Back-to-back hits have him in a good position to maybe stretch out this one-run lead.
Digging in now, Danny Espinosa. He'll swing it from the left side right here.
And you know, guys, he's not quite as successful when he's batting left-handed in general. He tends to have more success from the other side.
Looking to keep this a one-run game.
Couldn't quite pull that swing back. He went around for strike one.
Very weakly on the ground. And he indeed takes only the out at first as the runners move to second and third with one away now.
Yeah, just a little tapper here, but this is going to wind up being pretty effective because with one away now, it's going to move both guys up 90 feet to second and third.
Jesus Montero will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
Jesus Montero.
Looks like a left-hander has begun to get loose out in that Mets bullpen. Just off the outside, and it's 1-0.
And this is a critical point right here. Things are in danger of getting away from you, so you got to suck it up.
Swing and a miss as he ramps up on the fastball, 1-1.
Well, he'll lean pretty heavily on that fastball. Why not? It's a big one.
He's set. Here comes the 1-1. 1-2. Right. 4-3 our score here as we play the eighth. Swing and a miss. A big strikeout, and he's one out away from working out of a jam.
Now, he was really late on this one. I mean, really late. You can see where the baseball is by the time he gets the barrel through. I mean, it's darn near in the catcher's glove already. That tells me he was probably looking for something else.
Daniel Murphy will stand in now in what could be one of the big...
And what he has to do right here is put his 0 for 4 out of his mind. He hasn't had the greatest of performances to this point in the game, but he could make up for it with a big hit right here.
Now time is called, and this might be to buy a little time for that reliever to get loose.
Your attention, please.
So a call to the bullpen now, and they'll make a move for the left-hander here.
Sherry Levin.
Daniel Murphy will be his first assignment as he steps in with two men in scoring position now, but also two away.
Well, he's 0-for-4 coming into this at-bat, so I think he's happy to see a new arm out there. Maybe his luck will change.
Lagares is going to get there, and that's the third out. Nats leave a pair, but they hold on to a 4-3 lead. Drew Storen is on out of the bullpen now as he'll take over to start the bottom of the eighth.
Drew Storen.
Leading off the inning, Bryant Tiner, as they'll look to get something going here and even this game up.
Well, this has been a great game so far, and they're only down by one, so getting this leadoff guy on would be huge for them.
Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. And he swings through a fastball and doesn't catch up with it. It's 0-1.
You know, a lot of times with a sinker baller out there, you're just conditioned to always look for something down. So he can surprise you with that high fastball, maybe four-seam it every once in a while. And when he does, you can forget it.
Here's a late swing and a miss, strike two.
A lot of people think that pitch will burn straight down, but it will work back a little bit towards righties, like that one did right there.
Set to deliver on nothing and two, here it comes. Oh, and he dusted him off the plate that time. Some mind games being played now. It's 1-2.
You got to be careful with that inside location on 0-2. The last thing you want to do is hit him.
Ball and two strikes, here it is.
That's a ball.
Off the plate that time and a little high. It's even at 2-2.
Well, he kind of got caught chasing those first two pitches out of the strike zone, but I think he's caught on to their little game now. Two tough pitches that he took with two strikes, and a count now 2-2.
He's set. Here's the 2-2. And that misses there, so he runs the count full now. One thing that man right there will not tolerate, leadoff walks.
Especially right out of the bullpen. This might be a quick outing if that happens.
Here comes the payoff pitch. And he lays off ball four. So now the potential tying run here is aboard late in the game.
That's a real good at-bat there.
He fell behind 1-2 right out of the gate, but instead of going out of the zone to protect, he was able to lay off three straight and get his guys a leadoff base runner.
Quick check on that tying run at first. And the runner back.
Had a pretty good lead right there.
Perhaps wisely, another look to first. And he just manages to get his hand in.
Just keeping an eye on him.
Here's Yoenis Cespedes. As the first pitch sinker misses to him, it's ball one.
Well, not really how you want to start the next guy after a walk. That pitch isn't even close.
Throw over to first, and he'll get back in safely. And another throw over, and the runner back safely. One and oh pitch on the way. In for a strike, it's 1-1. Nobody out, runner on first. And a sinker dips too low there. Into the dirt, in fact. Nothing inside here, at least not to start the at-bat, and I imagine that's by design.
Yeah, they'll give him right field. They just don't want him to turn on something.
set to deliver on 2-1.
Ball three here as that pitch runs way up and in and backs him out of the box here.
He will definitely give you something to think about up there. There are no comfortable at-bats against this guy.
And that is in there at the letters to run it full 3-2.
And after you move a guy off the plate and you know he's all worked up, that's a perfect time to drop a curveball or a changeup on him. Great pitch call right there.
And before the 3-2, a move to first. And a dive, but he's back in.
Keeping an eye on him.
And again a throw. And he'll dive back in safely.
Simple throw over there.
And again a throw. And he'll dive back in. Crowd gets up for the 3-2. Swing and a miss on the slider, and that's out number one.
That's a big strikeout here with that tying run still at first. And now you're basically ground ball away from getting out of this.
So a pivotal moment here, and digging in now, Basil Padilla. And he does so representing the possible go-ahead run.
Yeah, but you got to make sure that he doesn't try to do too much here. Just keep that line moving. Do something productive and give the next guy a chance as well.
And now time is called for and granted by home plate umpire Clyde Washington. Another look to first. And he has to dive, but he's back in easily. He's set. Here it comes. And he's no doubt searching for a ground ball here as this sinker dips below the knees. It's 1-0. Runner at first here, one man out. Runs outside, so it goes to 2-0 now. Quick check on that tying run at first. And a dive, but he's back. And another throw over. And the runner back. Runners on first with one down. And there he goes towards second. Late swing on the hitter's count. Still a good count for him now, however, at 2-1. Now a move over to first. And a dive, but he's back in there. Runner at first here, one man out. And again a throw, and he'll get back in safely. Once more, a throw over. Runner back safely. And the pitch on 2-1. Pitch is a cold strike. The throw, not in time as he steals second.
Oh, and you know, we see it so often. The running game can really influence the outcome of a ball game. And here, he's representing the tying run, but he's able to use that speed to take second base with one out.
A throw behind the runner at second, back in standing. One out and a runner on second base. Look out. Don't want to hit him there. It's full 3-2. That man's team has definitely shot itself in the foot with all the strikeouts so far.
It seems like it's been a growing trend so far, but man, you've just got to be able to put the ball in play when you've got runners in scoring position.
Out in front of that one. May have been looking fastball. Good job just to make contact. Now a look and a throw back to second. And he'll get back in standing. Now a spin and another throw back to second, keeping particularly close tabs on him.
And now he'll go back to second another time here. And the fans don't like this at all.
Okay, no way he does it again, right?
Trying to hold the lead. And this one misses here. A close pitch on 3-2, but Clyde Washington rules it ball four.
Well, that's okay. You would have liked him to chase on 3-2, but you had your base open here, so now you can really focus on getting yourself a ground ball.
Blake Treinen will get the call now as he'll try to get the final two outs here and get this one on to the ninth inning. So striding in, number 11, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. Spin and a throw back to second, runners back. Now the double steal is on here. Pitch misses low. The throw down. And he'll just hang on as both runners move into scoring position now.
And we're going to take a good look at this double steal from the camera well up here near us. You can see that both guys get about the same jump, and that moves each of them into scoring position now with just one out.
One oh count, here it is. Bounced weakly near the plate. Gonna be a tough play, and he'll be tagged out as he got caught between third and home. Travis d'Arnaud will step in now in a big spot here in a game as close as this one.
And a chance at redemption, too, because he hasn't done much through his first three plate appearances, but he could make up for all of that with a base hit right here.
Drilled right back up the middle, and that is through into center field, a base hit. Long throw to the plate, but not in time, and just like that, this ball game is tied.
Up next for the
huge hit for his ball club right there. A single drives in the tying run. Boy, he's fired up down there.
Trey Kearney will be summoned now to be the pinch runner.
Number 28, Trey Kearney.
Neil Walker steps in for a big at-bat in this one. Two on, two away here in the eighth.
Yeah, this is a huge moment in this ballgame, Matt. I mean, you might be looking at this at-bat when it's all over as one of the turning points in this game.
From the belt, kicks and deals. On the ground to the right side. Murphy showing off his range. And the throw to first is in time, but the damage has been done as the side is retired. But the tying run comes across here, so it looks like this could be a wire job. Ninth inning coming up, and we are tied 4-4. Trey Kearney will stay in the ballgame as he'll likely do the catching from here out.
Now catching, number 28. Trey Kearney.
Now in the box, Denard Span. Already two for two. We'll look to add on right here.
Center fielder.
Now time is called, and this might be to buy a little time for that reliever to get loose. Now the skipper's on his way out toward the home plate area, and I believe that means we're going to have a double switch here. Jerry Familia will enter now to start the ninth inning, as his job will be keeping the game tied until the bottom half.
Jerry Familia. Now catching and batting in the ninth spot, number 31, Martin.
Into the box now, Denard Span. He's 2 for 4 in the ballgame.
Center fielder, Denard Span.
Here we go with inning number 9 as the first pitch misses for ball 1. Swing and a ball lifted in the air toward the line and right. Tyner is there, one quick out to start inning number 9.
Now batting, left fielder, Bryce Harper.
Bryce Harper comes forward, and he'll try to replicate what he did back in the 6th, that being a home run, of course. And a high strike there, 0-1.
And against a guy like this, you're usually only going to get one pitch to hit in that bat. Sometimes you might not even get that, so that's one he may want back.
Chopped at the plate. Piazza gonna have to hurry in time to first, and there are two away.
And at this point in the game, your defenders will love you for this. He's been able to pick up the first two outs of the inning here on just 4 pitches.
Wilson Ramos digs in, coming off a single in his last at-bat. Now here's the pitch. The fastball here is, we'll take a look at ball 1, 1-0. That evens it up, 1-1. Here it comes on 1-1. That's in there on the outer half. 1-2 now.
And guys, this has been just what the doctor ordered out of the bullpen.
Yeah, they needed him to come in and give them a strong inning, and he's done exactly that.
Late making contact on that swing, and will do it again on 1-2. Fought off at the plate, and we'll do it again. The 1-2 offering looked like a slider that time, but it's 2-2.
And this is where he gets so tough. He's seen everything you've got, but you still got to make one more good pitch to get him out.
This one misses, and that'll fill the count here. 3-2 with 2 away.
Wow, what an at-bat he's having right now. He's fought off some tough pitches. He's laid off a few pitches like that one. And now he's worked his way back to a 3-2 count.
This is line to left. Cespedes is under it, and he makes the catch for out number three. Three up, three down for Washington. Still all square at four apiece. Aaron Barrett will come on needing to get three outs here to try to send this game to extra innings.
Aaron Barrett.
Digging in, Mark Piazza. He'll get to take his first cuts
here. Here at the bottom of the ninth, catcher Mark Piazza.
And this is taken outside for ball one. A good tailing fastball for a strike, 1-1. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Hot shot on the ground is short. Espinoza's up with it, and the throw to first is in time, one gone.
The batter number six, shortstop, Alonzo Cochran.
Alonzo Cochran digs in now after lining out in his last try.
Yeah, he put a good swing on it last time, so we'll see if he can make one fall here.
I had him guessing that time as he's barely able to foul it away. On its way, the 0-1 pitch. Big swing and a miss at the fastball, and he's behind in the count 0-2.
That thing's coming in there hot, 96 miles an hour.
One out, nobody on. And he couldn't get him to chase the 0-2 fastball. It's 1-2. Fastball, strike three called as he couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away.
Two quick outs here to start the inning. It's looking more and more likely that we're going to need extra innings here to decide this one.
Digging in, Juan Lagares. He flew out in his last at-bat. From the stretch. Into the seats, 0-1. Pitch swung on and hit in the air. On the move is Spann. And that ends the inning. Down in order go the Mets. Score remains tied at four. Ryan Zimmerman gets another crack right here. He's got a hit in three tries to this point.
Ryan Zimmerman.
Now the pitch. And he lays off a pitch in there for the first strike. Slider, and he can't pull the trigger. Two strikes.
And they may have found a location that they like right here. Two different pitches, both taken on the inside corner. And now they can go just about anywhere they want.
He's ready. Here's the 0-2 pitch. And a good sinker there gets him swinging for the first out.
Well, there's the true definition of a power arm out of the bullpen. He just reared back and said, go ahead, try to hit it. And he blew that four-seamer right by the guy.
Here's the first baseman, Adam LaRoche. Now a ball hit fouled off to the right side, and that just about got the first base coach.
He's ready. Here's the 0-1. Swing and a miss as LaRoche finds himself in a quick 0-2 hole here.
And sometimes you got to cut down a little stride against a guy who's throwing this hard. Either you take that leg kick completely out of the equation, or you get it started just a little bit quicker.
This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Lagares has a beat on it. He's got it, and there are two down now.
Two quick outs here to start things off. Can't ask for much more than this in extra innings. Hold, serve, and then give your guys a shot to win in the bottom half.
Jason Worth ready for another at-bat now. He's 2-for-3 so far.
Yeah, and you can bet he'd love to get himself that third hit. Those are the kind of games that puts a little extra pep in your step.
And he catches the inside corner for a called strike. Nothing and one. One of the things that makes him so tough to hit, the ability to put his pitches right on the black.
Yeah, I mean, you watch the catcher's glove on some of these, and it literally does not move. That's how good his stuff is.
And they go away here. It's a called strike. Nothing in two.
Down 0-2 after two great sliders. He's got his work cut out for him now.
Now a sharply hit ball back up the middle. That's in for a base hit. He's now 3-for-4.
Oh, yeah, he's got that magic wand going now. That's his third hit in four trips, all of them singles. And he's been a tough out all game long.
Danny Espinoza will step in, a ground out victim his last time. From the stretch, here's the pitch. This is hit the other way out toward left field. Cespedes is there. He makes the play, and that'll end the inning. One left for Washington. This game's all tied at 4. Bryant Tiner steps in to get the home side started here in the 10th.
Well, you know, he's been on base twice in this one already, so let's see if he can do it again.
Pitch on the way. Now a swing and a miss as they start him out on a pitch well inside for strike one. Swing and he pops him up over toward foul territory. And that's going to land foul. And a waste pitch there, 1-2.
Not a real good 0-2 there. You don't necessarily want it in the zone, but you do want to at least give him something to think about.
Swing and a miss, and that'll get a groan from the home supporters here. One away.
And obviously, any time you can strike this guy out, you'll take it. I mean, he runs like a greyhound. So even routine grounders can sometimes be turned into base hits. Not when you're not making contact, though.
Here's the left fielder, Yoenis Cespedes, as he'll swing and miss at a first pitch slider at strike one.
Yeah, and you're going to see a lot of swings like that in extra innings. Guys go up there thinking, I'm going to take one chance here and see if I can't end this thing right now and be the hero.
Swing and a miss on the slider, and he's quickly behind, nothing and two. He's gotten that pitch past him twice here. Now, do you push your luck or give him something else?
Let it ride. Keep it out of the zone. See if he'll chase.
0-2. Here it is. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball.
Yeah, with the bases empty, that's the right spot for that 0-2 pitch. Make him see if he'll chase that slider.
Bases are empty. One man out. To two balls and two strikes now.
And when he's down 0-2, he's smart enough to know guys are going to try and get him to chase. So now at 2-2, he's got himself back to a spot where he doesn't have to go after a pitcher's pitch.
And now this ball's lifted in the air down the right field line, but this will get back into the seats, so the count holds at 2-2. Line toward the alley in left center. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit. And he needed extra innings to get it, but there's his first hit of the game, and that'll keep the hit streak alive and kicking.
Well, I'll tell you what, that's amazing, too. When you think about a hit streak, all the luck you need to go along with that tremendous skill. He needed the extra innings, but got him and got it done.
In now, Basil Padilla, as he'll chase one up around the letters here for strike one. A look at the hit totals there into extra innings. Possible winning run on first, one man away. Gets the fastball by him here, and he's in control 0-2.
And if he swung at that first one, no reason not to go up there again.
Chopped weakly to the left. To second for one. On to first, and he really paid the price at second base, but it's a double play, and the inning is over. Around the horn they go. 5-4-3 to end the threat. 10 innings in the books. On to the 11th. Still tied. Rolando Henderson will come on now, as it'll be the closer's job to try to keep this ball game even here in the 11th. And we're going to see a pinch hitter in this spot as the right-handed batting Kevin Franzen begins to loosen up on deck.
Leading off for Washington, second baseman.
Now a fastball to start things out. And a good heater as he just watches this baby, a ball and a strike.
I think he had to take that one because I'm not even sure he saw it.
Ah, and he took something off of it there. It's 1-2.
Hard to believe he let that one go. That was right on a platter for him.
Ready on 1-2. And that misses 2-2. Hit on the ground to short. To his left, Cochran throws in time, and that's out number one.
Well, with two strikes, you've got to protect up there, even on a curveball that's a borderline strike. But he can only manage to get this one off the end of his bat, and it winds up being a simple little ground out.
Here's Daniel Murphy now, fouled at home plate. One out, nobody on. And 1-1 as this one's in on the hands. This is in the air for Cespedes in left. And that's out number two.
Well, you know, he had the right idea up there, so at least you know he's thinking. He tried to go the other way with this ball, but he got under it just a little bit, and it's an easy play out there in left field.
Denard Span will stand in. He flew out his last time up. Here it comes. Drops one down here, and he'll try to beat it out. throw, not in time, and he's in there with his third hit of the afternoon.
Let's check this out again. This is in show motion, and you'll see how he shows bunt late. He's got his head right on the baseball, watching it all the way under the barrel of the bat. That's as good a form as you're going to see.
Here's Bryce Harper now. As this is popped foul behind the plate, it's strike one. Two out with the possible go-ahead run at first. On the ground to the left side. Throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired. Nationals leave one. Still all square at four apiece. Will Snyder will take over now to start the home 11th, knowing that just one would be the end of this ballgame.
Snyder.
Robert Vinson stands into the box. He could really use a knock here. 0 for 3 in the game so far.
Vinson.
Well hit the other way, and it's into the gap. Around first, on his way to second now. And just like that, the winning run is into second base with a leadoff double.
What a great job of leading off that inning with a double. You put yourself in scoring position, a chance to win this ballgame now, and he is pumped up out there at second base.
David Wright will come off the bench now as he'll pinch hit with the runner at second and nobody out. Not his best effort that time. It's strike one.
With the game on the line here, you got to make sure you're going after strikes.
Now a pickoff play at second, just keeping him close. And he'll turn and throw back to second again. A dive, but he's back. Now the 0-1. And he watches one dip low and inside for a ball, 1-1.
And against a veteran hitter like this, you got to be in that strike zone early in the count, because the more pitches he sees, the better he's going to be able to time anything you've got.
And here's a pitch swung on and missed, 1-2 now. Is that really the spot you want to be messing with here?
It shouldn't be. That's a danger zone if you ask me.
A possible winning run on second. No one out. Fastball misses in the dirt as he tried to get him to chase the low one. Now here's a ground ball up the middle and into center field for a base hit. Now a long throw home. And they're going to walk off here with a 5-4 win.
And he's going to get mobbed for that one. What a great at-bat here as he just comes through in the clutch and drives home that winning run from second base.
Well, a pretty good offensive show of force in this one. Probably at least a couple of players deserving. But, gentlemen, let's go ahead and give this man the nod as our top player of the game.
Yeah, and I think we probably could have given this award to three or four different people, but you definitely can't overlook his contribution. He really played a great ball game.
So that'll just about do it. For Eric Caro, Steve Lyons, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. This has been a presentation of MLB The Show. For more, don't forget to check out theshownation.com. The Mets come out on top, 5-4. So long from New York.